yet he was still a student to it. He wanted to know what made her heart about. And she was far from surprised when he talked to her friends about the car. But what worried her was that the doctor had asked him to complete the mission to pursue Sirocco. It's not a dream. It's just a man. He never would have known that Sirocco's friend was fitted. And now he's going to walk out. She had no idea what he had been experiencing, but each time she was near him, she felt a tremor. And she lowered her eyes and she listened to him, knowing that her cousin would be very angry with her for chasing him to her closest friend and toxic sister.
I have behaved very badly, Lucy, she said without looking up at him. I am too forward with you. It is only,
she said softly, looking up at him.
It is only that I think of you as a cousin.
But he shook his head as he listened. You have done nothing wrong, Hiroko, nothing. The trouble is, I do not think of you as a cousin.
I am deeply sorry, she said, her head bowed so low he couldn't see her face. I have been badly behaved and presumed much. I have been rude.
He wanted to cry himself when he saw her.
He smiled and took her hand in his. It was like holding a butterfly while she seemed so fragile. Your rude may have resumed anything. I don't think of you as a cousin, he said breathlessly, wondering if he could even say the words to turn me up knowing he had to. I think of you as something much, much more important than that. Perhaps it's your only thing that I want to mention. I have tried to sell myself to Hiroko each time I see him, each time I meet him. He told her, and rubbed on me.
Spark in the night that sets our hearts and minds ablaze with a burning desire to be more. This is what was stolen from the gods above. Not just fire, but something primal and hungry. A piece of life itself that devours the cold, hard facts around us, and through divine grace gives us warmth. Something to hang on to when the nights grow cold. The promise of better days ahead, not by the will of the gods, but by our own hands. And by the fires we keep stoked deep inside. Their lights granting us visions to follow, to build a world full of light and warmth. This is what Prometheus stole from us. Not just fire, but the embers to life itself. Picture speaks a thousand words, so I'll paint a picture in your mind with the words flowing from a silver tongue. My serenade a snapshot, each word a brick or a board to build the foundation for the theater of your mind. Till you swear you can see it. Even in the dark, my words burn bright. And when my voice grows weary and soft, my words will remain. We immortalize ourselves in the words we speak. Our manifestos and memoirs are our progeny. Simple words outlive men, kings, and kingdoms alike. Long after my bones are dust, the words I spoke will still echo on. Not to everyone, but to those who would dare have the courage to listen and paint a world of beauty for themselves. Like a dandelion, my feelings creep up, sprouting from nowhere. And as the wind takes them away, only the wind knows where it will go, and only the seeds know how it will grow. Darkness is just an absence, absence of the light and the warmth. It is nothing on its own, just like the thoughts that haunt me so. They are but the absence of the truth that you whisper, that I am enough. So when I die, bury me in the garden, and may dandelions bloom each year, spreading all the love that I had left but was unable to give to those that I would leave, and let their gardens flourish with this loving mess of weeds. I love language. Words are the brushes that are used to paint better days. But sitting down, I must stop and be silent. In the cacophony of the quiet, when words falter and leave me yearning to scream and be heard, to be seen, to be loved, that moment of death between the beats of my heart, all that I hear is my echoed cries. Selfishly, I cry louder. Words abandoned, an animal howling. Is this what I am? No. This is what I could be. Consumed by what they say I need. To be seen by all. Loved by all. I need only see myself for what I am not. I am not broken. I am not unworthy of love. I am not the accumulation of my mistakes. The sins of the Father do not chain me to the same fate. I am the words that I choose to be. A memoir of love. A biography written in the lacquer of those that I love. I am enough.
He would have married her at that moment.
We must be very wise, Peter.
powerful frontier, she said. Perhaps we must be very strong and give up what we want most. We cannot hurt anyone, Peterson. I cannot do that, she said as tears rolled down her cheeks slowly. But as he held her close again, she knew how much she loved him.
Will you go for a walk with me tomorrow afternoon? Peter asked nervously. Perhaps we can talk about this some more. Maybe we could even go to a movie. Hiroko looked at him, unable to believe what was happening to him, and she nodded. Although she had never been alone with any man except her father in Japan, she knew she could trust Peter Jenkins. Peter came to pick her up the following afternoon, and as it turned out, no one else was home. Hiroko was wearing a dark green kimono, which was a serious color for her, but she was in a serious mood as they walked along slowly together. Peter explained again how he felt about her, and when he had realized the first time that he loved her, she had known how to do. She had tried to act out, and she was still a little taken aback by her own emotions and the fact that I felt the same way toward her. But each time she had seen him, she had been aware of an irresistible pull in his direction. And now they have both given in to irrevocable forces.
What are we going to do, Peter?
She asked him again, looking deeply troubled. She didn't want to hurt anyone or betray her ancestor. She had not come to America to disgrace her family or damage their honor. Yet a part of her told her she had come here to find him, and she could no longer turn away from what had happened. We have to be very sensible, Sir Lucas, and very wise.
I don't know.
alive. Many things can happen between now and then. Perhaps I can come to Japan to see your father next summer. The fact that I scarcely knew her was the one thing that didn't trouble her at all. He would have been prepared to marry a man found by a go-between, and she would have known him even less than she knew Peter Jenkins. The problem they shared was that he was not Japanese, and that was potentially an insurmountable obstacle between them.